I focus my presentation about two points. The first, the low-risk myelodysplastic syndrome, and second, the high-risk myelodysplastic syndrome. So in the first part, I discuss the drug in development. So first, the luspatercept, second, the roxadustat, and third, imetelstat. So I discuss the results of the phase 3 evaluating a luspatercept is in ring sideroblast myelodysplastic syndrome. So the main results of the luspatercept was an increase of transfusion independency in patients treated by luspatercept versus placebo in this in the phase 3 clinical trial, and we observe a long transfusion independency and multiple transfusion independency in patient treating with a long term treatment. So this treatment seems to be very promising, and I hope it will be available very soon. The second treatment is the imetelstat. So this is a first in class telomerase inhibitor. So today we have only the results of the phase 2. We observe also a good rate of transfusion independency, and phase 3 is ongoing. And the third treatment is the roxadustat. We have only the results of the phase 1 with also a good rate of transfusion independency, and phase 3 is also ongoing. In the second part of the presentation, I discuss the treatment in high-risk MDS, and I focus on three drugs in combination with azacitidine. First, APR246 in TP53 mutated MDS, pevonedostat in all patients, and magrolimab in all also high-risk MDS. The main results first for APR246 was an increase of response rate around 60%, and an increase also of overall survival in this specific high-risk disease, with a median overall survival at 12 months. For the pevonedostat, it was a phase 2 randomized study, and we observed an increase of event-free survival in MDS population with a median duration of response about 34, that's 6 months. So this is a really good result, and phase 3 is ongoing. And to finish, the magrolimab, so this is the results of the phase 1, and the main results show an overall response rate at 91%, including 42 complete remission, and phase 3 is also ongoing. So as you can see, today we have a big development in myelodysplastic syndrome for low-risk myelodysplastic syndrome in a patient needing transfusion. So we will have, we hope in the future, a new treatment in patient resistant or in relapse after erythroid stimulating agent. And for the high-risk MDS, we have also a big development and I think we, in the future, we will have access to new drug in combination with azacitidine in high risk in this high risk population.